do have one member of the public for public comment when we get there.
Okay, I think we are there.
Okay, Chairwoman. Dan Weecks is our speaker.
Thank you, staff.
Good morning, Madam Chair and subcommittee members, and congratulations, Madam Vice Mayor, on your reelection as well. My name is Dan Weecks, and I'm the public information officer for a nonprofit agency in the Valley called Companion Pets in Crisis, or CPiC for short. When a life-altering event like a house fire happens, most people are not prepared, and it can be devastating both emotionally and financially. Feeling overwhelmed in such a crisis can cause pet owners to feel like they have no other option but to surrender their pets to an overcrowded kill shelter or take other devastating action. So Companion Pets in Crisis was founded on the principle that nobody should ever be faced with that decision. So imagine returning home to find that your house is surrounded by fire engines and your house is on fire because an electrical fire broke out, but your dog and your cat are still inside. A few years ago, you would be on your own to take care of your animals, find the cat, and then deal with the aftermath. But fortunately, Lisa Martin was a crisis responder for the City of Phoenix Fire Department and decided to bridge the gap and fill the critical void between human care from the fire department and pet care, which was non-existent at the time. So Lisa founded Companion Pets in Crisis, which is a first response agency for pets, similar to a fire department's crisis response unit. When CPIC gets activated by a partner agency like a local fire department or the American Red Cross when there's a 911 crisis call involving pets, a response team is immediately deployed to the scene. And our trained responders can provide on-scene emotional support, search and rescue services, loss of life care and services, pet food, pet supplies, and even emergency temporary shelter in certain cases. So all of this is volunteer-based and expensive, but entirely donation-driven. So today during the subcommittee meeting about critical infrastructure and innovation, I wanted to introduce this topic to the council and make you aware of this fairly new emergency response service in the Valley in hopes of brainstorming with your offices for new methods in which to fund operations, as well as to further educate the public about fire and pet safety. So since this is just the initial comment session with no discourse, I thank you for your time, and I'll reach out to your offices individually at a later date.
Thank you very much. It sounds like a very needed service. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you. I'll look forward to speaking with you further.